Now that we know what the team roles are, let's talk about how these roles can work together in the most efficient way possible. It's important to know not only what to communicate, but also how to communicate with your team, regardless of your role. Use these elements of effective team dynamics to practice good communication in a team. Clear roles and responsibilities.
James and Aaron, can you two cycle through chest compressions for the first rounds?
All team members need to know their jobs and responsibilities. The team leader should define these immediately. Knowing your limitations.
You can swap out compressions every 2 minutes or sooner if you get tired. Okay.
Team members should be aware of their limitations and ask for assistance early, not when the situation deteriorates. Constructive interventions.
James, you should provide continuous compressions and I'll give a breath every 8 seconds.
Are you sure? I think it's 30 to 2 until we get an advanced airway.
You're right, James. Good catch.
A team member or team leader may need to correct actions that are incorrect. It's important to be tactful when delivering this correction to a colleague. Knowledge sharing.
Kayla, can you provide a summary of the action so far?
We've inserted an IV and attached a monitor. We're due to analyze in 20 seconds.
Team leaders should frequently ask for observations from team members about possible oversights to improve team management. Summarizing and reevaluating.
We're a VLS crew with a 16-year-old male here, witnessed cardiac arrest precisely 3 minutes ago. It has been easy to bag.
Okay, thank you.
Summarizing information out loud is a good way to maintain an ongoing record of treatment and to reevaluate the team's progress within the algorithm of care. Closed-loop communications.
Aaron, if a shock is indicated, resume compressions while the defib charges.
Okay.
The team leader should call people by their names when he or she gives an order. Team members should then confirm that they heard and understood the order before letting the team leader know the intervention is complete. Clear messages.
Do we have an IV?
No, I'm working on the IV now.
Laura, if you can't find the first stick, try an IO.
Okay.
Use concise and clear language to help prevent misunderstandings. Speaking in a tone of voice that is loud enough to understand, but also calm and confident. Mutual respect.
You're right, James. Good catch.
All team members should display mutual respect and a professional attitude to other team members. Because emotions can run high during a resuscitation attempt, it's important that the team leader speaks in a friendly and controlled voice. Debriefing. Debriefing as a team during and after a resuscitation attempt helps individual team members perform better and brings awareness to system strengths and efficiencies.